Welcome to Chatterbox Quilts. I'm Kim. I had a question from one of the members of my Facebook group about showing her how to use a ruler to cut your fabric. So that's a basic thing to do, but it's a very important thing to know how to do properly. So I want to walk you through how I do it. And remember, there's always other ways of doing this. This is just the way I found that works well for me. So I have a piece of fabric here. And the first thing you want to do is, you know, you can't cut with the fabric. You know, we don't have 40-inch rulers, so you're going to have to make this small enough to be able to cut. So I'm going to match up my selvages. It's the first step. And when I match up the selvages, I want to make sure I hold it up, and I want to make sure that the selvages are matching at the top and that the fabric is straight at the bottom, that it hangs evenly. Not sure how to exactly explain to you except to show you when it's not working right. So when it's not working right, it looks like this. You're going to have these kind of folds coming across in your fabric. All right, that's not going to be straight when you go to cut it. You're going to get wonky edges. It's not going to be good. So what you do is you just shuffle your selvages a little bit back and forth. And I can move my hands over sometimes. You'll get used to this. And I want to get it so the fabric hangs straight. So that looks good on this side to me. I think that's pretty good. And then I'm going to lay it down. I'm still hanging on to the selvages. But I'm going to lay it down on my cutting mat. And then I'm going to take that selvage edges, I should say, there's two of them, and I'm going to bring them up to the fold that I created. And the same thing, I want to make sure this is lying nice and flat. Okay, and there's going to be a way to check this to make sure I didn't make any mistakes as I went along. I'll show you in a few minutes after we've made our first cut. So the first thing you want to do is straighten the edge. What we mean by straighten the edge is we cut it so it's going to be, all the edges are going to be even. All right, so I am using rulers to do this. I need two rulers and my cutting mat and my rotary cutter, of course. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move my fabric along, and I'm actually lining up that folded edge, the bottom folded edge. The selvages are still at the top. I'm lining that up with a line on the mat, not the ruler. Not yet. It's coming, though. Okay, I'm not really going to be using my mat too much for lining things up, but I like to have it lined up this way just to start. It's kind of just how my mind works. If it's crooked on there, it throws me off. So just go with me on this, okay? All right, now what I want to do is I want to take one of my rulers, doesn't matter what size ruler it is, and I want to line up one of the horizontal marks on the ruler with that bottom fold, okay? And one thing I forgot to mention to you is when you're putting this along here, when you're putting your fabric down, is sometimes the underneath fabric may be way over, okay? Depends on how much you had to shift that fabric. So I am going to use one of the vertical lines, sort of, on my mat. So I want to make sure that if I'm going to use this line, for example, on my mat, that all my fabric extends past that line. Okay, you don't want to cut. When you cut, you want to make sure you're cutting through all four layers of fabric. You don't want to just cut through two or three, for example. Okay, back to doing what I was doing here. So I'm laying this ruler down. I'm matching up just any of the horizontal lines, doesn't matter which one, with that bottom fold. All right, so that looks good. And now I'm going to take my second ruler. So I'm putting my hand on this one to keep it where it is. Match up my second ruler here. Make sure nothing has shifted. I'm going to push it right against that ruler. Not too hard, but you want them right against each other. Okay? And then I'm putting my hand, my left hand, on this ruler. Okay? And the pressure is there. And I'm going to take this ruler off because I don't need it now. Okay? So now we should have, because we were straight this way, and we're straight this way now, we should have a perfect cut. Okay, so now you can see all my four edges are all cut the same. They all match up. This is just excess, but it is helpful to open it up and take a look. Let me see if I can move this out of the way a little bit so you can see what I'm doing here. This is my straight edge that I cut. Okay, now this is not going to be straight, obviously, but what I want to see is I want to line it up with one of the lines on my cutting mat. And I want to see if it's going to be straight along here. Okay. So it looks pretty good. Got a bit of a bubble there, but that's beside the fact. Okay. So what I don't want to see is as I move this along here, that this all of a sudden goes up like this. And you'll see that happening if your fabric wasn't perfectly straight when you cut it. Okay. It'll go along. It'll kind of go, you'll have little bumpies in it. Okay. That means it's not straight. You need to go back to the start over again. Okay. Straighten that fabric with the selvages and everything because you didn't have it quite straight. That's what the problem is. So that's how I straighten my edges. I'd like to invite you to join my private Chatterbox Quilts Facebook group, and you can do this by going to www.chatterboxquilts.com/FBgroup. That's FBGROUP. We have lots of discussions on quilting topics and vintage sewing machines. I'd love to have you join us there.